stewardship. And stewardship is just being a custodian, taking care of what someone has entrusted unto you, or whatever you have, being a good custodian, stewardship, being a leader of yourself, being a leader of whatever you have. Psalms 24, verse 1 to 2. So everything you see belongs to God. He created the heavens and the earth. He laid foundations. Praise God. Your life is founded on the rock, so strong that even the rivers themselves, they flow from the foundation that God laid. You yourself, you belong to God. You belong to God. Yeah, because some people are misbehaving carelessly because they don't know whatever the endeavors they are in belongs to God. You yourself, you belong to God. The earth they are in belongs to God. And the word that you use, it was there. This word we are using, it was there. We've been reading the Bible from John chapter 1, the beginning. God created the heavens, the earth, isn't you? And it continues saying that this word created the world, and then the world, when the world was created, it came and dwelt in the same word. Praise God. Meaning that everything, and he laid the foundation of the season, established it on the rivers. Rivers. Do you have rivers in your life that can flow and tell you, please, as you flow in worship, as you flow in your talk, as you flow in your academics, as you flow, remember you should flow in a way that will glorify God. Why? Because there is something that God expects. The Bible says that in every word that will come out of your mouth, you bring an account. And that's what Revelation says, that there are books which will be taken. There are book and there are books. Mm-hmm. There are book and there are books. The book, it's where you found whether you're born again or not. Then there are books that contain the account of everything you did in this world. Praise God. Mm-hmm. What do I mean? I mean we should be good stewards. Stewards of what? Good stewards. You should be a good steward. Stewards of time. Praise God. Amen. Allow me to tell us the reason as why we need to be good stewards. One of the things you need to be a good steward to be fruitful. Praise God. Amen. You need to be a good steward to be what? Fruitful. Why should I say this? In whatever things you're doing, whether in school, whether in your room, there must be a purpose of you doing that thing. Why are you in church tonight in this fellowship? Because there is a reason, a purpose for you to be here. So you are a good steward of yourself and of your time. Praise God. Amen. If you could not be a good steward of yourself, you could not have chosen to come to church. How many are there? You could have chosen to sleep, to go to, and then someone today has a bash. You could have chosen to tell them and let join him. But because you're good stewards of yourself and good stewards of your time, that's why you chose to be here. And that's at the end of this fellowship, you'll give an account. How have you worshipped? How have you listened to the preaching? How have you appreciated the actual ministry and praise and worship? Praise God. Amen. Giving an account in everything, not just one thing, but everything you do, you'll have to bring an account of this thing. So that we say, good fruit of what you've been trusted. Job chapter 15. John chapter 15. From verse 1 can help us. So that you may know, why do we talk of being fruitful as a good steward? Steward of yourself. Yourself. I'm just there. Steward of you. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine here. Praise God.
Amen.
He is a vineyard keeper. He is the vine presser. Who is you, master? Who is your vineyard dresser? Who keeps you? And the Bible continues to say that every branch in me that does not produce fruit, he does what? He removes and he prunes. What? So that it will produce more what? But there is a reason as to why God prunes us. There is a reason why God prunes us. If you fail to be a good steward, and God sees, I am the true vine, you are attached to the vine, you are a branch, he has entrusted you, that then I'm a prepare that he calls you, you can attach yourself to the branch, to that vine, and you can tap the nutrients, you can tap the water, and you can produce. But he sees that you are not heeding to his word. He tells you, tap the water, tap the nutrients, whatever you need from the soil, for the vine. But you say, I can do these things without God. And then God says, okay, you are branch and faithful branch, I want to prune you. Isaiah 54 talks of, sometimes God just hides himself for a little while. Praise God. Sometimes your master can hide for a little while. Why? Sometimes if you are a teacher, principal can just hide and just pretend. He overlooks, just pretend. He's not seeing whatever you're doing. Because at the end of the day, he wants to see the fruits. So what do I mean? Be a steward of yourself. Praise God. The second thing is be a steward of your time. Time when? When should you be a good steward? Praise God. Steward of time. Redeeming the time. Because the days are evil. A good steward redeems time. The time you have. But I tell us, yes, we have free time, as you can say. But I tell you, free time without responsibility is useless. Praise God. If you have free time, but you don't know how you're going to use this time, it is very much useless. If you have property and you don't know how to use them, it's useless. Remember the story of the prodigal son? Given what he wanted to receive. At the end of the day, he became a bad custodian. He did not follow what was supposed to be done. He wasted all the money, all that he has been given. And that's why at the end of the day, he comes back to himself and says, how many had servants in my master's, in my father's house? They can eat, they can sleep. He remembers, I was not a good steward. I was not a good child. I was not presenting myself well before my father. Praise Jesus. So when we talk of being a steward of a good time, we need to understand that the times we are living, we're living in a day where generation is purpose, where you can choose what to do. Anytime. If you choose work, now you want to walk out, you can walk. If you choose now, I want just to reach out and get to MP, you just do exactly that to give a helper. Praise God. But my point is, how do you use your time and to do what? And what is the main purpose of you using that time and doing that exact thing that you're doing? What is the main purpose? Praise Jesus. And that's why God is so merciful. But I tell us, when you use your time in a wrong way, and God corrects you, God chastens you, kindly, you need to consult God and why God has corrected me and come back to your senses and say, God, yes, you are divine. When you prune me, I have to accept. Accept to be pruned. Accept to pass through a challenge. As a good steward calls for sufferings. Because sometimes you're forced to do what you don't want to do. Sometimes you're from class and it's late and you're forced to come arrange instruments. It calls for a lot. And you need to sacrifice. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
So allow me to tell, to continue. Steward of, I've talked of myself, stewards of mind, of what? Time. And now I want to talk of stewards of your body. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Don't expect me to talk of stewards of Kazi Kubwa. No. I want to tell us as Christians what you need to be a good custodian of your body. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And being the temple of the Holy Spirit, it means that you have to take care of it so that it may be always clean. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Ask your friend, is your body clean? You know, your body houses a very precious thing. Your soul, praise Jesus, your heart. And God says, I do look at what? The heart, not the countenance. Not what people see. There is 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 8 over there. But God looks, not the appearance. Praise Jesus. He looked at that heart. How have you kept it? The environment that houses your soul, your body. How have you kept your body? Is it divine? Are you a good steward who can say, today I want to wash my body. Today I want to keep my body in peace that I am not stressed. I want when I go before God as a good custodian, as a good steward, I just keep myself there, praise God,
amen.
And present and pour out my soul before the Lord. Amen. How have you treated your body? Is it in a way that when you present that body before God, it can give God glory or not? And sometimes people do console themselves and say, Hakuna shida, God looks at the heart. Ati mwili haya is vitu. Hata nikivalia aje, no. Ati hata nikiongea aje, Mungu anaangalia mwili. Praise Jesus. But my question is, where is your soul found? Where is your heart that God looks found? Sometimes, once upon a time, during the ages of Lot, Lot went to a place called Sodom and Gomorrah. Praise Jesus. And that city was full of prostitution and also we call immorality. And that is an environment that surrounded Lot. And Lot, being righteous before God, there's something that prevented God from going direct to speak to Lot. Praise Jesus. And that was the environment that he was living in. And that's why he talks to Abraham and tells him, I will do what? I'll destroy the city. I will destroy those people. But tell Lot to go to escape from the place. And that he pleads to God, what if I found right, will you destroy the city? What if five? He says, they will not. How evil was that city? The environment, being a custodian of your body. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Another thing is being a custodian of your gift and talent. If you cannot know which is your gift, which is your talent, there is no way you can take care of that gift. Praise God. If you don't know what you have as a gift, you cannot know how you can use a way to nurture it and to bring it. Praise Jesus. It's just like you are doing a course, you're pursuing a course and you don't know what it takes. You don't know what you need to do and you just say, I know I'm an engineer, praise God. I know. Yes, but nothing you can do, nothing you're doing, praise God. You need to be a good custodian of your gift. So that you not use your gift to glorify men, praise God. So that you not use your gift to take praises from people. Praise Jesus. And what do people say you are? Can people say, this guy respect the gift that he has? This guy respect the talents he has? How good can you take care of your gift? Yes, we know you're good as singer, but how good have you shown to others? Has it given glory to God? And you know, unasema, hata tukimba secular, isn't a gift kutoka kwa Mungu? So you're using it kusema, Mungu ndiye alinipea. But is that construction, composing of your song, glorifying God, good custodian of your gift? Let's read from the book of Psalms. Oh, we can just bring it from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 6. 2 Timothy 1, 6, before 20 Psalms. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 6. Putting a place, that gift that God has given you. Amen. To the glory of God. I bless the gift of God that is in you through the laying of my hands. Praise Jesus. Which is come to Nasema, I'm very humble. Staki your story, kujionyesha, city, when you are gift. But the word says, therefore, I remind you. Tell your friend,
therefore I remind you
to put ablaze the gift of God. That is in you.
Acha
kutuambia umekalia tu. That gift as a good steward, you must show that you are producing a gift. A gift, it multiplies. Praise God.
Amen.
If you have a gift of intercession, you pray. Praise God.
Amen.
Until it blesses someone. If you have a gift of mission, evangelism, you preach until some people are convinced. Till they say, this is a good steward of God, and I have to submit my life. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Lifestyle evangelism, because you are a good steward of your own self, draws people to come and say, wow, this kind of life, this kind of people, I wish to have such life. Amen?
Amen.
Why? Because we have challenges that we are having today that are making us not to produce a blessing thing to God. The gift, you're not really lifting it to God in prayer. Why? Because of what is happening, the challenges that we are having today. And one of the challenges is wrong misconception we are having concerning the ownership. Amen. We have wrong misconception of what we have, what God has given to you, what you are having. And I said, si sauti tu inapeamba watu when you are present worship. So you know, they are the ones who have that gift. And I said, see my A's in first class, it's our sin. Well, what do I do? Wrong. But the Bible says, for I have blessed you with every spiritual gift according to my purpose. Amen. I have blessed you with every spiritual gift. I have given it to you. I want to say, imepewa hawa say, praise Jesus. What do you have in your hands that you can present before God? You know that problem you're having because of that wrong misconception. We say that everything happens for good as stewards. Hata ukijapwa na mkubwa, unasema, everything happens for good. But the question to ask tonight, what is that reason, that good? Praise Jesus. Umefail mtihani ukapata F ama D. Then, Abbas, Romans It encourages you and tells you what? Everything happens for the good of God, the lovers. It's a good steward. Tragedy. Press. And you say, everything. This used to is bad. Is bad. And then we say, everything happens for the good. And we don't have seat. But the question is, what kind of good is this? Happens for the reason. What kind of reason is this? Yes, God prunes me. I am sick. I'm in the stairs. I'm a worshiper, but I am sick. And the Bible says, I have healed it through all my stripes. You are healed. But now as you speak, you are sick. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Then the verse comes. And everything, even sickness, happens for the good of you who love Jesus. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Good steward. Sometimes a good steward passes through wilderness. Praise God. In a wilderness where they found there is no hope. No one can help them. Your friend runs away. And you are there as a steward. Where will I go? Your friends have run away. Your parents have said, no, where will you grow? But a question comes in that wilderness, where do you put your trust in? Some put trust in chariots, some in princes, some in whatever they have. But the battle belongs to God. A good steward. Sometimes I do encourage myself as a good steward of God's word. I do try to follow the word of God, but it challenges me to a point of I'm sick, yes. But I take time and thank God. And tell God, thank you, Jesus. I am sick. And I'm not sick because you cannot help me. But I'm sick because you still remind me that, Kimans, you are still a human being. Praise God.
Amen.
Yes, you are an apostle. Paul, but you have been a God in your flesh. You are praying for people. Yes, you have it. A good steward, you passing through some issues. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
And as I'm almost concluding, a good steward of your heart. A good steward of your heart. When you talk of your heart, there are things that emanate out of our hearts. From the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. The values, what you produce, you are a good steward of your heart. Because when Bible says, na chenye unasema unatoa kwa mdomo yako, it is what comes from your heart. Meaning that there is some words you can say until we see your heart is rotten. Praise God. Be a good steward of your heart. Because you know your heart, even based on the kind of words that will proceed from your mouth. A good steward. A good steward. Another steward. Where you can be a good steward. A good steward of the relationship. Praise Jesus. Good steward of relationship. What do I mean? Relationship with your friend. Relationship with your family. Relationship with whomever is around you. Good relationship. How do you take care of your friend? What kinds of words do you speak? Either to or against your friend. Be a good steward. What kind of things do you say concerning the leadership of the team? What kind of things do you say concerning the vice chancellor? What kinds of words do you say concerning your roommate? Akitok, the relationship. Praise Jesus. Are you a good steward of the relationship you are in? Ama unasema, go say, wejama, nampenda, lakini. Praise Jesus. I love her, but where are you having the but from? And you're a good steward. Do you expect a smooth life? When God corrects you, say, Jesus, God, I listen. I am wrong. God, you're right. Chasten me. Prune me. I be a better steward of what I have been. Praise Jesus. We have many things I can speak about, like stewards of resources that you have been, and many other things. But allow me to finish by telling us about I talked of challenges, yes, they are there. But let you be a good role model to others in whatever you're doing. That God may be exalted and may be glorified in whatever things you are showing. Good student of what you have, the resources, the money that you have. I do not want to be a person in Bible. Am I with you? Good stewards of yourself, the resources you have, they all belong to God. Before you use that money, ask God, God, as I make a decision to do this, to buy this, is it right, God? Help me do it. And if it's not according to your way, Mungu nisaidie nisifanye. Alafu ukienda kufanya kitu, unataka kubai kitu, unajua kitu, haitakuwa for the glory of God. Unasema, hata nikinunua hii nguo ilipotea. Na nimenunua tu jana nimepotea leo. Kuna kakitu kaliniambia nikiwa tu daraja. Anaambia tu. Nisinunue hii nguo. Lakini kitu kingine anaambia ni nzuri. Yeah, bye tu. Consulting God. Na tuache ku replace Mungu tunasema. Master. Nasikia kakitu kaniambia. Kakitu. The Holy Spirit speak to us. In a small still voice, this is the way you walk in this. But we say, praise God. We need to understand good servants, he is. And you know what? The Bible says that be careful. It's a good steward. Whatever you are speaking against the master. The master is God. The master is what we are. Be careful, because there is a bad, praise God, that takes the information to the master. Amen. And that's why in our high school, ngefanya kitu, pinzi anajua, ajandu na mtu, na mulisengenya sengenya mwalimu hapo, na amedua, unaitua. What happens? Nasa kusema, ku pinzi huyu, kwanga na mamu. I just imagine by kuna tukutu anatumianga like nakwanga na to spirits twake. So I'm a prince. My prince wanakwanga na kuna. But I tell you, whatever word you speak, kichaka iko na masikio. Praise God. A bad comes and tells, najua nini? Wana fulani walisema hivi. Uje unamuliza mtu, by the way jana mlikuwa mnanisema nini? Hata kusikia kitu, unashangaa, Daniel, alisema story yetu, unachukia Daniel. And therefore is very calm. Mnakuwa sana, because of something you said, thinking that Mungu awaone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Good stewards. Amen.
Amen.
I want to say that God is good to us, and we need to be good stewards. Whatever God has entrusted to you, use it, glorify God, support each other as a good steward, support every other steward. Praise God. Usifanye kazi kwa shambani na like, hey, say, nani maji? Maji. Be a good steward of whatever God has given you, and especially in the ministry, because there is an account of what you will give. Yes, mi tumekuwa tukisava hapa lakini yon behavior ya prison worship haijanipendeza. Sitaki kanyanga yo church. We have to fly. A good steward. Driven. Stop driven. No matter the challenge. No matter the issues you face. No matter sicknesses. In times of trouble, remember to say, oh God, even in the deepest moments, the sorrows, the darkest moments, I thank you because I can at least see a light breaking through and coming on my way. Sometimes we are facing a lot of challenges and we're like, am I still born again? Am I still praying to the right God? God of such a times. You have a friend, you have a fellowship, but sometimes, yes, you are good stewards of Christ, but sometimes they are prayer warriors, they are prayer partners, but sometimes it forces you to separate yourself from the fellowship. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus went to pray, and the disciples, sometimes they failed in Jesus. Yes, wanaomba. They are good stewards, but what can fail? Now, we have John, James, and Peter, help me pray. The hour has come. But these guys are not understanding. Praise Jesus. When pressure of Jesus, the pressure mounts and mounts and increases, these guys are not understanding. Do you have another steward who can take care of you? Do you have an accountability partner who can be a good steward of your life? Such that when you tell them about a problem, they can even tell you, I'm fasting specifically because of you. Because I'm a good steward of who you life. Praise Jesus. But Jesus, sometimes, atakama, you're very close to me. Sometimes stewardship takes initiative, personal initiative. A choice, you know, say, atakama, you say to Nambanga and first night, I live what I'm going through. Jesus only knows me. Unajikata. Yes, unajikata. Pray, anaenda. But at that time,